We get an error while trying to add repeated OnGroup nodes, but we should of course do the same for grouped nodes. Thankfully for us, Unity provides us with some callbacks in their GraphView API that makes it easy to know when a node was added or removed from a group, and we are gonna use them to help us out. So let's go back to our GraphView script, and in here we'll be creating another dictionary that will hold our grouped nodes. So type in private, serializable dictionary, to which the key type will be grouped, because we want to give an error to grouped nodes and not to the groups themselves, so we don't really need to know the group name, but just what group the node belongs to. And the value type will actually be another dictionary. This dictionary will basically be the same as our OnGroupNodes dictionary. It will hold the name of the nodes and the list of nodes that have that name. This will allow us to know if there is a node with a repeated name inside of our group. So pass in serializable dictionary, of key type string, and of value type dsNodeErrorData. Then I'll name it GroupedNodes. Of course, don't forget to initialize this list in our constructor. Let's start this off by adding a grouped node whenever a node is added to a group. To do that, we'll be making use of the elementsAddedToGroup callback the GraphView provides. So let's create a new method right under our other callback, to which I'll name onGroupElementsAdded, and inside we'll start by overriding the callback with our own. So type in elementsAddedToGroup equals to a callback which accepts two parameters. The first parameter is the group to which the elements will be added, and the second parameter are the elements that will be added to the group. Inside this callback, we'll simply iterate through each of those elements, and if they are of type dsNode, we'll do a few things. We'll remove them from the onGroupNodes dictionary, in which we can do with our removeOnGroup method we've created before, and then add them to the groupNodes dictionary, in which we'll create a method for in a bit. This will work because when we start making our removal method, we'll do the opposite. We will remove them from the groupNodes dictionary, and then add them to the onGroupNodes dictionary. That means that whenever a node is being added to a group, it will always be an ungrouped node, no matter where it was previously. That also means the removal callback will be called before the addition callback. Let's start by iterating through our elements with a forEach loop by typing in forEach, graph element, element in elements, and inside we'll do an if check statement to see if the element is of type node. So type in if element is dsNode. And we only want to do something if it is of the node type, so we'll actually place this between parentheses and add a not operator, continuing to the next element if the element is not of type dsNode. Then we can remove our node and add it to the group. To get our node, we'll create a variable of type dsNode, to which I'll name node, and set it to be the element, to which we need to cast it. We won't be using the pattern matching here because we are using it outside of the if statement, and to me it feels kinda weird to use it here. I believe it works if you prefer it to. Then we simply call in remove and group node and pass in our node to it. For us to make our node a grouped node, we'll need both the node that we want to add in and the group we want to add the node into. Thankfully, we have both of them already, so let's create a new method which I'll call addGroupedNode and pass in our node and our group. Make sure it's part of the repeated elements region and it's also public. In here, we'll create a new variable of type string to which I'll call nodeName and set it to be node.dialogName. This is just so we do not need to type in node.dialogName every time we need a node name. Then we'll need to do a few things. If the dictionary doesn't contain the given group as a key, we need to initialize a new element with it. That's because we'll only initialize an element in this dictionary if a node goes inside of a group, and not when a group is created, because until then a group node doesn't exist on that group. Then, if the dictionary with the key of group doesn't have the node name in its value key, we need to initialize a new element there as well, with the node added to its list. If it does have the node name in its value key, we simply add a new node to that dictionary value. Of course, in the last case, we need to set our node error colors as well, as it means they are repeated names. So let's start with our first if check statement by typing in if group nodes.containsKey of group and make sure you have the not operator before everything. We then simply create a new one by typing in group nodes.add and pass in group for the key, and a new serializable dictionary with the key string for the node name and the sNodeError data for the list of the nodes. Then we create the next if check statement by typing in if group nodes at the key of group does not contain the key of node name. Note that this contains key is for the nodes dictionary that we got from the group nodes at the key of group. Inside, we will do the same as in our onGroupNodes method, which is simply create a new variable of type dsNodeErrorData, to which I'll name NodeErrorData and call its constructor. Then we add our node to this variable nodes list. When that's done, we simply need to add a new element to the group nodes dictionary value, so type in group nodes at the key of group dot add and pass in node name as a key and node error data as a value. Our group now has a node with a so far unique name added into it, so we simply return at the end. All that's left is to make the part of the code where the group already has a node with its name on it. So all we really need to do here is to add another node to the already existing nodes list and set its error color. So simply type in group nodes at the key of group, which receives a nodes dictionary, so we'll also make sure we are at the dictionary key of node name, and access its nodes list by typing in .nodes, and add our node through the add method. When that's done, we'll need to set its error color. Of course, do not forget we'll need to set the error color for the first added node, much like in our onGroupNodes method. To do that, create a variable of type color, to which I'll name error color, and get it through the nodes dictionary. So group nodes at the key of group, at the key of node name, and .errordata.color. Then we update its color by typing in node.setErrorStyle and pass in our error color. Once that's done, we'll need to update the first node color if the other node is a second node. So create a new if check statement by typing in if group nodes at group at node name dot nodes.count equals equals 2. We are already seeing the repetitive usage of the nodes list, so let's create a new variable above of type list of dsNode, which I'll name group nodes list, and assign the value of group nodes at group at node name dot nodes. Make sure to swap their usages with this variable. Then inside the if statement, type in group nodes list at the index of 0 dot set error style with our error color. We have our element added to group method done, but we of course need to call our onGroupElementsAdded method in our constructor so that the callback is overrided, so feel free to do that. If we save and go to Unity, we shall now have the nodes show an error when we add them into a group. Of course, this doesn't work properly yet as we haven't done the callback for the removal of the nodes from a group. So let's go back to our GraphQL script and under our onGroupElementsAdded method, we'll create a new one which I'll name onGroupElementsRemoved. In here, we'll be overriding the elementsRemovedFromGroup callback, to which we pass in the same parameters as our elementsAddedToGroup callback. The group the elements will be removed from, and the elements that will be removed. In our callback, we'll also iterate to our elements list using a for each loop, to which I'll just type in the same as above, and continue to the next element if it is not of type TSNode. In this loop, per element, we'll be removing them from the group nodes dictionary and add them to the OnGroup nodes dictionary. And to do that, we'll be needing both our node and the group it belongs to. We already have our group, and we already have our node variable that we copied from the code above. So, the first thing we want to do is to remove this node from its current group. I'll type in a comment here saying remove node from its group. And then we want to add this node to the OnGroupNodes dictionary. So we simply type in add OnGroupNode and pass in our node. In our comment above, I'll swap it with a new method we'll be creating named RemoveGroupedNode and pass in both our node and our group as arguments. In our method, we'll basically do what we did in our RemoveOnGroupedNode method. We will remove this node from the group and reset its styles. Then, if the node count in this group is equal to 1, we will be resetting the only node left styles as well. If the node's count is 0, we will simply remove the node element from the nodes dictionary, which is the group nodes value, as that means there are no nodes in this group with that name anymore. Of course, if the nodes dictionary count gets to 0, it means there are no nodes left in the group, so we can simply remove it from the group nodes dictionary. So let's start by creating a variable for our node dialog name, which I'll name node name. Then we will remove this node from the group node dictionary by typing in group nodes at group at node name dot nodes dot remove and pass in our node. Remember that our nodes are in the group nodes value, which is another dictionary. So we are first accessing a certain group nodes which are in a dictionary, and then accessing the list of nodes with a certain name on that nodes dictionary. Of course, we can just pass this into our variable of type list, much like in the other methods. So type in a list of type TSNode, and I'll name it group nodes list equals to group node at group at node name dot nodes. When that's done, simply swap it in our removal. After removing the nodes, we will reset its styles by typing in node.resetStyle. Then, if our nodes count get 1, we'll also need to reset the only node left styles. So type in if group nodes list dot count equals equals 1, we will reset its styles by typing in group nodes list at the index of 0 dot reset style. All that's left is to remove the node and the group if the count gets to 0. So type in if group nodes list dot count equals equals 0 and remove the nodes dictionary element by typing in group nodes at group dot remove the element with the key of node name. This will remove the element of the nodes dictionary that has the given node name. Of course, if that nodes dictionary count gets to 0, it means there are no repeated node names in that group, so we can simply remove it from the group nodes dictionary. To do that, type in if group nodes at group.count equals equals 0, we remove it by typing in group nodes.remove and pass in group. And the method is now done. I'll make this method be under our AddGroupedNode method and also make it be public. Don't forget to call our OnGroupElementsRemoved callback method in the constructor for the callback to be overrided. If we save and go to Unity, our error should be working whenever we add or remove from a group. However, we still have one problem here, and that's when we rename a group dialog. Whenever we try to do that, it should throw an error, That's simply because when we update the name, we are removing them from the OnGroupNodes dictionary, which it currently isn't in. What we are going to do is really simple. We'll check if it is in a group, and if it is, remove from the group nodes instead. Of course, we are also going to add it to the group nodes instead. So let's go to our DSNode script and start this off by creating a property of type group, to which I'll name group. We'll use this variable to know if this node has a group or not. And of course, to be able to do that, we'll need to update this variable whenever we add it into a group and whenever we remove it from a group. So back to our graphical script. In our AddGroupNode method, we simply type in node.group equals to the group we've passed in. The same in our RemoveGroupedNode. We type in node.group equals null, meaning it is no longer part of a group. You can add this code at the end of the method if you prefer, just in case some error happens until there, but I'll leave it here. That's done, so back to our DSNode script, we'll need to update our dialogNameTextField callback. We'll simply put our current removal and addition code inside of an if check statement which will pass in group equals equals null. And return it at the end so that the next code isn't executed. Then we'll do the exact same code without the if check statement, but remove and add to the group nodes dictionary. So type in graphview.removeGroupedNode and pass in our node with this keyword, as well as our current group. Then we update its name by typing in dialog name equals callback.newValue. And then add it to the group node dictionary with graphview.addGroupNode and pass in this and group. However, you might remember that in our removeGroupedNode method, we make our node group null. So we need to create a temporary variable above our method call that will hold our group before it is set to null, so that we can pass it into our addGroupedNode method. So let's create a group variable to which I'll name currentGroup and equal it to group. Then we pass in the currentGroup variable instead of the group variable in the addGroupedNode method. Going back to Unity, renaming the group node should work fine. We still have a problem when removing the nodes from a group. That's because in our OnElementsDeleted callback, we are removing them from the OnGroupNodes dictionary, which they currently aren't. What we are gonna do is check if they are in a group. And if they are, remove them from there using the removeElement method. Meaning the elementsRemovedFromGroup callback will be called and the node will become an ungrouped node. So in here, type in if node.group different than null. We say node.group.removeElement and pass in our node. If we save again, we shall now be able to remove them correctly.